A very good morning, students of class 12. Well, I was doing chemical properties of alcohols, if you remember. So let's continue from today. Well, you can see I have written a reaction with Grignard reagent. All of you know that Grignard reagents are alkyl magnesium halides. It could be aryl magnesium halide also. But for the time being, we are focusing our attention only on alkyl magnesium halides. So ROH plus R dash MgX gives R dash H plus RO MgX. So I've taken an example, methanol. Methanol is the IUPAC name of methyl alcohol. It reacts with ethyl magnesium bromide. Ethyl magnesium bromide is of course a Grignard reagent. So methanol reacts with ethyl magnesium bromide to form ethane plus CH3OMgBr. The next reaction is very important, of course. Why I am saying very important, you can understand because it comes in exam. So what is happening over here? When alcohols are treated with acid chloride or acid anhydride in the presence of bases like pyridine or dimethyl aniline as catalyst, the hydrogen atom of OH group is replaced by acyl group forming ester. So I have given two examples, acetyl chloride with ethanol in the presence of pyridine forming ethyl acetate CH3COOC2H5 plus HCl. The next reaction is of ethanol with acetic anhydride forming ethyl acetate again and acetic acid. Well, you have to copy down both the reactions, and I am giving a short note also. Please copy it down as I dictate. This reaction is called acylation reaction if the acid halide or anhydride used are acetyl chloride and acetic anhydride. The reaction is usually called acetylation, which means the introduction of acetyl group in alcohols. It may be noted that the reaction with acetyl chloride is carried out in the presence of a base, that is pyridine, to neutralize HCl, which is formed during the reaction. It shifts the equilibrium to the forward direction. Alright students, as you can see, I have given some reactions. The first reaction, of course, that I have written is that of phosphorus halides. Now phosphorus halides such as PCl5, PCl3, PBr3 or PI3 react with alcohols to form corresponding haloalkanes. Reaction with thionyl chloride. You know what is thionyl chloride, SOCl2. On treatment with thionyl chloride in the presence of pyridine, alcohols form chloroalkanes. For example, C2H5OH plus SOCl2 gives C2H5Cl plus HCl plus SO2. Now the reaction with thionyl chloride is preferred because the byproducts SO2 and HCl formed are gases and can be easily removed from the reaction mixture. Next, reaction with ammonia. When vapors of an alcohol and ammonia are passed over heated alumina Al2O3 at 633 Kelvin, a mixture of primary, secondary and tertiary amines is produced. For example, CH3CH2OH plus NH3 gives CH3CH2NH2 plus H2O. CH3CH2NH2 plus CH3CH2OH gives CH3CH2 whole twice NH plus H2O. CH3CH2 whole twice plus CH3CH2 whole twice NH plus CH3CH2OH gives CH3CH2 whole thrice N plus H2O. Children, please copy down these reactions. Alright students, now I'm going to discuss some important facts about dehydration of alcohol reaction. Now please note down whatever I am dictating. The acidic dehydration of alcohols to alkenes occurs through the formation of intermediate carbocation, and the stability of carbocation follows the order 3 degree greater than 2 degree greater than 1 degree. Therefore, the relative ease of dehydration of alcohols follows the same order: tertiary alcohol greater than secondary alcohol greater than primary alcohol. Now, the dehydration of 2 degree and 3 degree alcohols, that means I'm talking about secondary and tertiary alcohols. So, the dehydration of 2 degree and 3 degree alcohols always occurs in accordance with Zaitsev's rule. According to this reaction, the more highly substituted alkene is always the major product. In simple words, I would like to say the symmetrical alkene is always the major product. So, when butan-2-ol, which is a secondary alcohol, is treated with concentrated sulfuric acid at a temperature of around 443 Kelvin, we get two products: but-1-N, which is of course minor product, and but-2-N, which is of course the major product. So you can see between but-2-N and but-1-N, the symmetrical one is but-2-N. So according to Zaitsev's rule, but-2-N is the major product. Now it may be noted that the reaction between alcohol and concentrated sulfuric acid depends also upon the conditions. For example, at 443 Kelvin, it gives ethene as the product. Yes, I'm talking about ethanol. Ethyl alcohol, when treated with concentrated H2SO4 at a temperature of around 443 Kelvin, forms ethene. Now, when heated with excess of alcohol at 413 Kelvin, it forms an ether. Twice CH3CH2OH gives CH3CH2O CH2CH3. It is called diethyl ether. At 383 Kelvin, ethyl alcohol and sulfuric acid react to give ethyl hydrogen sulfate. CH3CH2OH plus H2SO4 gives CH3CH2HSO4 plus H2O. When ethyl hydrogen sulfate is heated to 413 Kelvin in the presence of excess of alcohol, diethyl ether is formed. CH3CH2HSO4 plus CH3CH2OH gives CH3CH2O CH2CH3 plus H2SO4. Well students, I was discussing about dehydration of alcohols. So, dehydration of alcohols to ethers or alkenes can also be brought about by passing the vapor of the alcohols over heated alumina catalyst under different conditions. At 513 to 523 Kelvin, ethers are obtained. You can see the reaction: twice CH3CH2OH gives CH3CH2O CH2CH3. Plus H2O. At 633 Kelvin, alkenes are obtained. CH3CH2OH gives CH2 double bond CH2 plus H2O. Children, please copy it down carefully. The first reaction I have written CH3CH2HSO4, that is ethyl hydrogen sulfate, when heated at around 443 Kelvin in presence of concentrated H2SO4, forms ethene, CH2 double bond CH2 plus H2SO4. Next, dehydration of alcohols to ether or alkene can be brought about also by passing the vapor of the alcohol over heated alumina catalyst under different conditions. So at 513 to 523 Kelvin, ethers are obtained. Please write it down. You can see twice CH3CH2OH heated in presence of alumina, heated alumina at a temperature of around 513 to 523 Kelvin, forming diethyl ether and H2O. At 633 Kelvin, alkenes are obtained. You can see CH3CH2OH when heated at around 633 Kelvin, ethene is obtained plus H2O. Now oxidation. Please write down the note that I am dictating. The oxidation of alcohols involves the formation of carbon-oxygen double bond with breaking of an OH and CH bonds. This type of breaking and formation of bonds occur in oxidation reactions. These reactions are also called dehydrogenation reactions because this involves loss of hydrogen from an alcohol. The product of oxidation reaction depends upon the type of alcohol, that is primary, secondary or tertiary, and also on the nature of oxidizing agent. The oxidation of alcohols can be carried out by a number of reagents such as aqueous alkaline or acidified KMnO4, acidified Na2Cr2O7 or K2Cr2O7, etc. However, different classes of alcohols differ from each other not only in their ease of oxidation but also on the nature of products formed. So you can see what I have written. CH3CH2OH when treated with acidified K2Cr2O7 forming acetaldehyde CH3CHO, and which on further oxidation forms acetic acid. Yes, always remember, primary alcohol when oxidized with a strong oxidizing agent like acidified K2Cr2O7 forms an aldehyde first, which on further oxidation will give you the carboxylic acid. Over here, ethyl alcohol is oxidized to give acetaldehyde, and then acetaldehyde is oxidized to form acetic acid. Now children, I'm talking about secondary alcohols. A secondary alcohol is easily oxidized to form a ketone with chromic anhydride, that is CrO3. The ketone may be further oxidized under strong conditions to form a mixture of acids. While the ketone contains the same number of carbon atoms as the starting alcohol, the acids formed contain lesser number of carbon atoms. You can see I have chosen propan-2-ol, which is also known as isopropyl alcohol. When it is oxidized, it forms propan-2-ol. Always remember, a 2-degree alcohol, that is a secondary alcohol, when oxidized will give you a ketone, which on further oxidation forms carboxylic acid. In this case, it is acetic acid. Next, I have taken pentan-2-ol, which on oxidation forms, of course, a ketone, pentan-2-ol. On further oxidation forms a mixture of acetic acid and propionic acid. Thank you.